Hey everybody, Mac here, and once again we have our Series 20 LEGO minifigure blind bags. Once again, full disclosure, I am not good at feeling around in the bag, so there may be a few doubles that we get from what we've opened already. And just as a reminder, here is our checklist with what we've got. We got the tournament knight, we got the Viking, which was very, very cool. We got the diver, we got the drone boy, and we got the 80s keytar player. And a lot of these minifigures give me an 80s vibe, especially like, oh yeah, and we got the, they call him a super warrior. This is basically the Red Ranger, like the Red Ranger, the Karate Kid, the keytar player. There was a couple of other ones, a break dancer. I mean, come on. A lot of these have an 80s vibe to them, which is why the aesthetics of this series are very much 80s. Like there's the hot pink and blue Miami Vice colored logo. And the music selection for these videos has all been inspired by the heavy 80s feel that these figures give me. So, we set this aside, and we will take a look at the three that we have opening today. Once again, any doubles that we get, I'll put up for sale on the Etsy store, unless it's something that I might want to keep a double of, like the Tournament Knight. I could use another Viking, or even the Super Warrior, the Red Ranger. I might keep doubles of those. So without further ado, let's rip this open and see what we get. Our first one is... oh, it's the Peapod guy. Alright, we'll put him together. We'll take a look at what he's got going on. I like the bowl of greens on his shirt. Little bit of a shirt collar printing there. But other than that, there's not much printing on this figure, which is understandable when you consider this is going to go on his head. And here's her headpiece. The green lipstick. I like the green lipstick. That's a really cool look. You might even be able to use this headpiece for another minifigure. Oh, and there are two head prints. The big smile and the smirk. I like the smirk better, so we're going to put that one out. And then the Peapod costume goes on top. And they really like their food-themed minifigures. I personally don't get it. They've never really done much for me. But fans seem to like them. So we have that. We have the stand. And we have this little apple piece. Which, let's see here. Let's put the stem in the hand. And there we go. I'm actually surprised there's no... no double pieces of this. Usually things like this we sometimes get two of in these packs. But that's pretty much our person, our Peapod lady. The sculpt of this part, let me get this off. The sculpt of this part is really good. I do like it. Like, I appreciate the work that goes into these food-themed minifigures. I just don't get it. But this is a really, really funky looking piece, and maybe that's really all the appeal is, that just the uniqueness of it. So we'll set that down for now, and set this stuff aside, and we'll cut into this one now, and see what we get so far. Oh, we got the pirate! Nice! This was the last one of the ones that I really, really wanted to get. So I'm real happy that, like, all my must-haves I've got covered now. This is cool. By the way, as I was feeling, in case anybody was wondering, the Peapod figure, honestly, I know I said I'm not good at feeling around, but the Peapod figure is a fairly easy figure to feel around for, because this piece is very, very unique, and it's easy enough to feel that out. With this one, I felt for this. I had assumed that this was the hairpiece and hat piece when I was feeling in there, so this was the piece that I looked for the pirate. Let's take a look at the body printing. We have the typical pirate blousey top. I like the leg printing on this with the boots. Is that dual? No, not dual molded. Black leggings. I really like the deco on this. Oh, a little pouch on back with the baldric and the belt. The ruffled collar on the front and back. Cinched at the waist. I like the gold trim along the boots. Let's take a look at the portrait printing. little bit of a piratey snarl right there, and a little bit of a cocked smile on her face. And is that? Looks like she has a bit of a chipped tooth, or that's just bad paint deco right there. Either way, it looks like a chipped tooth, and that works for this character. I think we're going to go with this one. I like the mole that they put on her. Just a little bit of detail. Pirate hat with the headpiece, the hair pulled back. This looks really good. I'm just going to call her Anne Bonny. And, of course, we have our little feathered plume for the tricorn hat. Cutlass. And stand. Really like this pirate figure. Like I said, this was the last of the must-haves. My must-haves were the pirate lady, the tournament knight, the Viking, and the super warrior, the Red Ranger. So those four have been taken care of. So I got all my must-haves, so I'm real happy about that. She looks real good. And as far as extra pieces go, we get another cutlass, which is always a bonus, and another little feathered hair piece for the, or feathered piece for the tricorn hat. Plume, that's the word I'm looking for. One more left. Let's open this up, and we'll see what we get. Haven't gotten any doubles so far, so hopefully we'll skip that. And the Karate Kid. The Nunchuck Kid. Another piece that made me think of the 80s. Man, this is a good haul this time. This is a real good haul. I like this. The paint deco on this is very basic, but what else are you expecting? I like the little brick symbol for his dojo. And of course, he's a black belt. I like that. Yeah. Very simple painting. Very simple paint app on this figure, but there's really not much else that you would need for it. I also like the headband. Once again, we got a little bit of a serious little curl to the lip right there. And we're going to go with the big cheeser. We're going to go with the big cheeser because I used the sneer on the last one. And a very Ralph Macchio looking hairpiece. I'm sorry, this is the Karate Kid. He's called like Nunchuck Kid, I think, officially on the LEGO site, but he's the Karate Kid, come on. And the nunchucks. Now, when I was feeling around in the bag, this was what I felt for this guy. I felt the chain link in here when I picked it up, when I felt the nunchucks. So that was what I looked for in this one. Mm-hmm. Oh, nice, you can. Cool. And there we go. He's a good looking guy. I like that fig. I like that one a lot. He wasn't one of my must-haves, but I'm glad he's one that I got. So we'll set him down there. And where's my pen? Go to our checklist. We will, let's zoom this down a little. Mark off the Peapod Lady. Mark off Karate Kid. And where's the pirate? And our lady pirates. So there we go. We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more to finish the 7? Yep, 7 more to finish the set. Wait, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. All right. Let's drop this down, we'll take a last look at them. I like these guys. I like this series a lot. There are some times with the LEGO Blind Bag series that not all of the characters really appeal to me, and I didn't really focus on getting an entire series until the last one we did with the DC Blind Bag. And then when I saw this, I thought there's enough in this set to interest me to make me want to get the whole thing. So, we've got some really good ones so far. That's what we have for you today. We'll be doing more of these blind bag openings, plus we have Halo Battle for the Arc blind bag opening, which we'll be finishing up in the next Halo video. Plus we have more videos coming out for Wonder May this month. So, thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed these three. I really like this one. This one's cool, but I'm really happy I got this one. Thank you all for watching. Play well, everyone. And as always, thank you for watching.